Welcome to this grade 11 mathematics lesson where we'll be exploring operation on matrices. My name is Ms. Donnell Phillips. Let's get started. Matrix definition. Suppose a school has four houses, house A, B, C, and D. An athletics contest between the houses has 20 events and the results are shown in the table below. So here we have the table of the houses, the number of firsts, the number of seconds, and the number of thirds. So for example, house A came first 4 times, second 7 times, and third twice. A table such as this is often called an array. There are 4 rows and 3 columns of numbers, and it is called a 4x3 array. We can simplify the array by writing it as a block of numbers, as shown below. An array written like this is called a matrix. Plural is matrices. Because it has 4 rows and 3 columns, it is called a 4x3 matrix. This is the order of the matrix. Some special orders are a matrix such as 2, 4, 5, which has only one row, is called a row matrix. And because it has one row but 3 columns, this is a 1x3 matrix. Then we have another example. This one has one column, but it has 3 rows. So this is a 3x1 matrix. And a matrix such as we have 1, 3, 4, 6, which has the same number of rows and the same number of columns. Now, this particular type of matrix is called a square matrix. And in this example, because it has 2 rows and 2 columns, it is a 2x2 matrix. So we have 3 examples here. For each, we're going to write down the order of each matrix. So for this example, we have to write down the order of each matrix. Now remember, when we're writing the order of the matrix, it's just the row by column. So the first thing we're going to do is look at the number of rows in the first one. So this is number 1, and this one has 2 rows. So the first one, we have 2 rows multiplied by how many columns does it have? 1, 2, 3. So this is a 2x3 column. The second one, number of rows, we have 1, 2, 3 rows. So this is a 3 by number of columns, 1, 2, 3. This is a 3x3 column. And lastly, this one, we have 1, 2, 3 rows. So the third one, we have 3 by 1, 2 columns. So this is a 3x2 column.
Addition and subtraction of matrices. Now, 2 matrices can be added or subtracted if they have the same order. We add or subtract the digits in corresponding positions. So let's look at the 2 matrices that we have below. The first one we have ABCD, and the second one we have EFGH. Because we're adding them, digit or letter A and letter E are in corresponding positions. So we would add letter A and letter E. Then B and F are in corresponding positions. So we add them. C and G are in corresponding positions also. And lastly, D and H are in corresponding positions. So as long as we're adding or subtracting matrices, we first need to ensure that they are the same order. If they aren't, if the 2 matrices that we're adding are not of the same order, then addition or subtraction would not be possible. Lastly, when we add in or subtracted, we need to ensure that we add or subtract the digits that are in corresponding positions. Examples. Number one, we have matrix M equal 1, 4, 7, negative 8. Matrix N, 11, 14, negative 17, and negative 6. And matrix P, 3, 8, 0, negative 18. Find A, M plus N, matrix M plus matrix N. B, matrix M subtract matrix N. And C, matrix P subtract matrix M. And for this next set of examples, we're given three matrices, M, N, and P, and we have to find M plus N, M subtract N, and P subtract M. So we know when we're adding or subtracting matrices, we need to ensure that we pair the corresponding elements in each. So if you look at the first one, we have 1 and 3 are in corresponding positions, 4 and 8, and so on. So we're gonna add. So for the first one, M, let me draw a big one. We have 1 plus 11, and then we have 7 plus negative 17, and then we have 4 plus 14, and lastly we have negative 8 plus negative 6. Right? So we're going to go ahead and we're going to add them. 1 plus 11 gives us 12. 4 plus 14, 18. 7 plus negative 17, negative 10. And negative 8 plus negative 6 gives us negative 14. So M plus N is equal to 12, 18, negative 10, negative 14. M subtract N would be, let's see what I paired. We have 1 subtract 1 and 11. So it's going to be 1 subtract 11. And then we're going to have 4 subtract 14. 7 subtract negative 17. 8 subtract negative 6. Negative 8 subtract negative 6. And we work. So this is equal to 1 subtract 11 is negative 10. 4 subtract 14, we have negative 10 again. 7 subtract negative 17, and we know that in this case, this is going to become a positive. So we now have 7 plus 17. And 7 plus 17 gives us 24. Same thing. Negative 8 subtract negative 6. This becomes negative 8 plus 6. And negative 8 plus 6 is negative 2. So M therefore, M subtract N is equal to negative 10, negative 10, 24, and 2. So now we're going to be working matrix P subtract matrix M. So let's set this down. So we have 3 subtract 1. Then we have 8 subtract 4. We have 0 subtract 7 and negative 18 subtract negative 8. Negative 18 subtract negative 8. We work.
So this is equal to 3 take away 1 is equal to 2. 8 take away 4 is 4. 0 take 7, negative 7. Negative 18 subtract negative 8. Remember, we have two negative signs coming together, so this actually becomes a positive. So negative 18 plus 8 becomes negative 10. Therefore, matrix P subtract matrix M is equal to 2, 4, negative 7, negative 10.
Multiplication of matrices by a scalar. Now, we can recall that a scalar is an ordinary number, such as 2. So if A is a matrix, then 2A would actually be equal to A plus A. If a matrix A is multiplied by a scalar K, then each element of A is multiplied by K. And we did explore this concept when we were multiplying vectors by scalars. It's the same principle. So we have a scalar quantity K that is multiplying a matrix that has elements A, B, C, D. So K times this particular matrix would be K times element A, K times B, K times C, and K times D. So whenever we have a scalar quantity multiplying a matrix, we have to take that scalar quantity and multiply every element in the particular matrix that is being multiplied. Examples, let A equal 2, 4, 5, 6, and B equal 3, negative 4, negative 8, negative 2. Find the following. First one, 2A. Next, negative 3B. 2A plus 3B. And lastly, negative 3B subtract 2A.
In this set of examples, we have matrix A equals 2, 4, 5, 6, and matrix B equal 3, negative 4, negative 8, and negative 2. We have to find the value of matrix 2A. So this is just 2 times matrix A, and matrix A is 2, 4, 5, 6. So this would be equal to 2 times 2, remember the 2 that is outside has to multiply everything inside of the bracket. So you're going to have 2 times 2, 2 times 4, 2 times 5, and 2 times 6. 2 times 2, 2 times 4, 2 times 5, and 2 times 6. This is equal to 2 twos, 4, 2 times 4, is 8, 2 times 5, 10, and 2 times 6 is 12. So this is 2A. Now we're going to find for minus 3B. So we now have a minus 3 that is multiplying everything inside of B. 2 minus 4 minus 8 minus 2. So this becomes minus 3 times 2 minus 3 times minus 4 minus 3 times minus 8 minus 3 times minus 2. Minus 2 times 2 is minus 6. Oh, this is actually 3, so this should be minus 3 times 3. So minus 3 times 3 gives us minus 9. Minus 3 times minus 4, when we have two negative signs multiplying each other, becomes a positive. So this is just 3 times 4, 12. Minus 3 times minus 8, again, the answer would be a positive. 3 times 8, 24. And minus 3 times minus 2, positive again. 3 twos, 6. So minus 3b is equal to minus 9, 12, 24, and 6. Now, We want to find, I hope this is not confusing. I'm going to put a line here to not confuse you. So we now want to find 2a plus 3b. We already found what 2a is. Remember, this here is 2a. And we know what minus 3b is. So if we know that minus 3b is equal to minus 9, 12, 24, and 6, we could know for sure. So if we know that minus 3b is minus 9, 12, 24, and 6, we know that positive 3b, all we have to do is change the sign. So this becomes positive 9, this becomes negative 12, negative 24, and negative 6. So this is 3b. So now that we have 2a and 3b, we could just go ahead and compute. Open the bracket. So we're adding 2a with 3b. So we would have 4 plus 9. Then 8 plus negative 12. 10 plus minus 24. And lastly, 12 plus negative 6. And we work that out. 9 and 4 gives us 13. 8 plus 12, 8 plus negative 12 gives us negative 4. 10 plus negative 24, negative 14. And 12 plus negative 6 is 6. So when we add 2a plus 3b, we get 13, negative 4, negative 14, and 6. So this is 2a plus 3b. So for the last problem, we have to calculate minus 3b subtract 2a. If you can recall, the second problem that we had to work was to calculate the value of minus 3b. So we know that minus 3b is equal to minus 9, 12, 24, and 6. And 2a is equal to 4, 8, 10, 12. So we're going to work. Minus 3b minus 2a is minus 9 minus 4. That's minus 9 minus 4. Minus 12 minus 8. Sorry. 12 minus 8. 24 minus 10. 24 minus 10. And lastly, 6 minus 12. 6 minus 12. So when we work this out, minus 9 minus 4 is equal to minus 13. 12 subtract 8 is equal to 4. 24 subtract 10 is equal to 14. And 6 minus 12 is equal to negative 6. So here you have it. Minus 3b minus 2a is equal to minus 13, 4, 14, and minus 6.
So to summarize today's lesson, A matrix is an array of numbers arranged in rows and columns. Next, we give the number of rows before the number of columns. So a 4x3 matrix has 4 rows and 3 columns. 2 matrices can be added or subtracted if they have the same order. We add or subtract the digits in corresponding positions. And lastly, if a matrix A is multiplied by a scalar K, then each element of A is multiplied by K. This has brought us to the end of this grade 11 mathematics lesson, where we explored operation on matrices. My name is Ms. Donnell Phillips. See you next time. Thank you.